And hi again, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien. Once again, welcome to Prudential's At the Half, a special edition. You know, this NBA All-Star game has become a spectacular event. It's not only All-Star Sunday, it is All-Star Weekend. And yesterday, for Hoop fans, it was Nirvana. They are legends in our minds, and yesterday they returned to the hardwood one more time to make us feel good again, to stand by us one more time. Well, the wheels may need a little retreading, the fashions and updating, but the great ones still have displays of elegance. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. And it provided a nostalgic backdrop for two men entering the Hall of Fame.
Well, to me, that's the ultimate honor any player can receive. And, you know, I'm just happy I was inducted.
Really, the Oscar of Basketball Achievement, it's something I never really dreamt of. My earthly goals were a lot lower than that, because that was something that I never really thought was reachable.
Well, there is no doubt Larry Bird will enter the Hall of Fame. He currently owns basketball's three-point stripe and the riches that go with it. Larry's feats here are legendary as well. So is his nervous system. Pressure does not penetrate Larry. For Detlef Schrempf, a winning check would pay for his forthcoming wedding. And he came so close as Bird went into an extra shootout to survive round one. But Larry Bird caught fire in the final round, hitting his first eight. And Detlef had one final shot for the golden honeymoon. And this one was for the money. But it wasn't to be. Not today.
I'm worried about Detlef at the end. It came down to one point.
Well, you had the last shot, and they took a $12,000 shot there and missed it.
How come you're not in the slam dunk contest?
I thought I was.
Well, this is what they came to see, the slam dunk contest. Even defending champ Spud Webb decided to leave it up to the tall guy. This, folks, was pure and simple Michael Jordan stage. And it was magic. He made the best jams look like jelly. Because as heaven knows, there is only one Mr. Jordan.
You told me this morning that 360s don't win slam dunk contests. I guess you're right. What wins them? Just leaping ability, or what do you think?
I think there's something that the people haven't seen. The gliding, the hanging, the pumping, the high you can get above the rim, that will win. And I just knew everybody could do a 360, so you know, I decided not to do it.
You can fly, can't you?
For a little while.
Everybody can do a 360. Air Jordan is certainly the future of the NBA, but we are sorry to say that the past will soon be Julius Erving. When we come back, a tribute to the doctor as Prudential's At the Half rolls on from Seattle after a word from your local station.
Soar beyond your expectations. Today, the
Jacques Demers, 6:30 Sunday on Sunday Times.
Well, you know, you walk around the Kingdome and talk to some of the fans, and each and every one of them is having a great time here at the NBA All-Star Game, and it is quite an event on this Sunday, the February of 8th. We do have some breaking news for you here on At the Half. Our producer, Mark Wolf, is now the proud father of twin boys. Lisa and the gang are doing fine. Now, Mark would be pleased to know that At the Half scooped him. He's on an airplane. He doesn't even know about it. He thinks it's a boy and a girl, so congratulations to the Wolf family. How does one say goodbye to the doctor? Well, it seems like we can't come up with enough thanks and praise for the man who has transcended the game of basketball. How do we say goodbye? We say thank you. Thank you, Dr. J, for all the house calls. Thank you, Doc, for mid-air highlights. Thanks, Jay, for the grace and the style. But most of all, thank you, Julius Erving, for teaching us all something about class.
I believe the children are future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children laugh.
Life after the basketball gives you the pleasure, the success, and the reward that life doing basketball provided for you.
People are going to say, well, Julius, why don't you play another year? You know, we're so sorry to see you retire. I'm ecstatic. You did it your way. Because you were the greatest as a player, as a person, and as a friend.
How do you thank the doctor? You say, thanks for the memory. There are more memories to be made here in Seattle. I'm Pat O'Brien. Thank you for joining us at Prudential's At the Half.